Hello everyone, I am Siddharthan. Currently we are in the sixth module of our hands-on machine learning course with Python, and this sixth module is all about training machine learning models. So in this video, let's discuss what is meant by supervised learning and what are the different supervised learning models that we have in machine learning. Actually, we have discussed about this topic in our first module, which was on machine learning basics, but I thought that it would be a good idea to revise the topics on supervised learning and unsupervised learning, as the upcoming videos will be completely on machine learning models. Okay, so that deeper understanding on these topics will be very helpful for us as we move on with the other topics. Okay, so let's get started with today's video. So what is meant by supervised learning? In supervised learning, the machine learning algorithm learns from labeled data. So the main thing to note about supervised learning is that we use labeled data set, whereas in the case of unsupervised learning, we use unlabeled data. So first of all, let's try to understand what is meant by this labeled data. Okay, let's say that we want a machine learning model to see an image and predict whether the image represents an apple or a mango. Okay, so whenever we take a supervised learning approach, we will label this data set. So all the images of apples will be labeled as apples, and all the images of mangoes will be labeled as mangoes. So you can also call this process as annotations, because we are annotating all the images. All these images will be annotated as apples, and all these images will be annotated as mangoes. Okay, so we are giving the images and the corresponding label to our machine learning model. So once it gets the data, it tries to map the images and the labels. Okay, so it tries to find the patterns between the images. So for example, it can understand that if the image is almost in red color, if the fruit is in red color, then it may represent apple. If the fruit is in yellow color, then it may represent mangoes. So kind of it tries to find all the features and all the patterns in those images. And once it learns from it, when you give a new image, an unknown image, it can tell you whether that image represents an apple or a mango. So the main thing to note here is that we use labels, and this is why it's called as a supervised learning. Here we are supervising the machine. So there is some supervision in terms of the labels. Okay, so that's why it's called as a supervised learning. And there are two main types of supervised learning. One is classification and the another one is regression. Okay, so what is meant by this classification? So classification is about predicting a class or a discrete values, whereas regression is about predicting a quantity or continuous value. So what is meant by this? So first of all, let's discuss about classification. What is meant by this class or discrete value? Okay, so these values are fixed. So it's just like classifying an object. So we can classify a person as male or female based on some features. We can have some medical data, and we can classify a person based on whether they have diabetes or not. Okay, so that is basically classification. So true or false is actually a classification. So it is a class. Male or female, it is also a type of classification. So these are discrete values. So likewise, we try to classify data. Whereas in the case of regression, we try to predict some quantity or continuous values. Okay, so it can be a decimal values, it can be some numerical values. Say for example, we are trying to predict the salary of a person based on their work experience, or we are trying to predict the age of a person based on some features. Or else we can try to predict what is the price of a house based on the number of rooms it has, and the square meters, and such kind of things. So those kind of problems are called as regression. So you can think about this. If we want to predict whether a person has diabetes or not, then it is a classification problem. Whereas if let's say that we want to find what is the blood sugar level based on some data, then it would be a regression, because we are predicting whether a person has diabetes or not. So this is a classification. Whereas in the case of blood sugar level, we want an accurate number. We want a continuous value. Hence, it is an example of a regression. So this is the example of a classification and regression. And let's try to understand this with another example as well. Let's say that we have images of dogs and cats, and we want our machine learning model to find or to predict the new images as whether that image represents a dog or a cat. So we feed these images to a machine learning model. As this is supervised learning, we will have labels. So all the images of dogs will be labeled as dog, and all the images of cat will be labeled as cat. So the work that our machine learning model has to do is to tell whether the image represents a dog or cat. Here we have two classes. The first class is dog, and the second class we have is cat, right? So it will just try to predict that class or category. Okay, so you can also think about this as category. Whereas in the case of regression, we want to predict some number, some value. So think about this example. It says that we have the values of temperature, and based on the daily temperature, we want to predict what will be the rainfall in centimeter. So here we are predicting the centimeter. So rainfall in centimeter, which is some kind of value, and we feed this data to our machine learning model, and it will tell you what is the rainfall in centimeter, which is a value, a particular numerical value. And hence, this is an example of a regression problem. Okay, so this is the difference between classification and regression. So what are the important supervised learning models that we use regularly? Okay, so let's try to understand that. So these are some of the main classification algorithm that we use. So the first one is logistic regression. So this logistic regression is very useful for binomial classification. So binomial classification is nothing but we just need to find two categories. The example which we have seen, dog or cat. So we have only two categories. So in the case of binomial classification, logistic regression is very useful. And there is another important classifier model called a support vector machine classifier. So support vector machine classifier tries to build a hyperplane that separates the data and it classifies them. So similarly, we have other models such as decision tree, k nearest neighbor, random forest, naive bayes classifier. So these are some of the important classification models. So in our upcoming videos, we will discuss in detail about each of these models. Okay, so just try to take note of these algorithms or these models. Okay, for this video, we can dive it deeper in the upcoming videos. And when we talk about regression, so these are some of the regression models. So linear regression, lasso regression, polynomial regression. So linear regression means it's just a line, just a straight line. And lasso regression and polynomial regression. So polynomial regression means it can be a curve. Instead of a line, it can be a curve. Similarly, we have a support vector machine for classifier as well as for regressor as well. Similarly, random forest can be used both for classification and the regressor. Only there will be some difference in their code. Okay, so some basic things will change between the models on how they approach that particular data set. So again, we have bias in linear regression. So we can use support vector machine and random forest for both classification and regression. So this is one thing which you need to take care of. And another thing which you need to take note of here is logistic regression is called as a regression model, but it can also be used for classification. Okay, so in most of the classification problems, we will be using classification regression. So in our YouTube channel, we have also did about 17 machine learning projects in that we did a lot of classification examples. Say for example, we tried to classify whether a news is a fake news or a real news using a logistic regression. We also used support vector machines for different classifications like diabetes prediction or predicting whether an object is a rock or a mine and so on. So you can refer those projects as well where we have did about several classification, and we have also did several regression problems such as predicting the Boston house price and also predicting the car price and insurance cost, etc. So these are examples of some regression problems. Okay, so this is about supervised learning and supervised learning models. And in the next video, I'll give you a recap on unsupervised learning and unsupervised learning models. Okay, so that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next upload. Thanks for watching.